guys, and what's up? So today I'm recording a part one of my three-part tutorial series in which I'm going to make our table. So this part is the basic modeling. The second part in which we are going to make the texturing, the final texturing, and then in the final part we will do the third part. We will do all our compositing and give it a nice render. So let's begin. Take the default cube, move it up, scale it on the z-axis, tab, click this, and then we might scale it even more on the z-axis. It's edit mode, it does not matter. Tab, we will select this side, and first we will extrude it on this side. So we are making a really basic T-shape, L-shaped table. E and Y on the Y-axis. So that's one of how it can look. You can edit it. Either you can make it straight or it actually depends on how you like it. And then Control R to add in a loop. Make it roughly squared. So we will select this, Control R, add in another loop and make it a rough square over there. Yeah, and Control R, another loop over here, another square. So basically we are currently creating the legs of this table. So it will come over here. Next we will bring it over here. And we want to add in another loop cut over here. So it's basically done. We will select that again, and we will select which legs we want to extrude. So I think these. No, that's not how a leg is. We will first extrude these four. Numpad 3, E, and bring them down. Bring it down again. G and Z and hit Control to snap it down. Or you can just press 1, G and Z. So you'll bring it to the same height. So that's how a table will be. So now let's get on to modeling these, the legs. So we will add in a Control R loop cut over here to all of our legs. So we will add them all. Next we will add in over here. And then we will bevel these. First of all, we will change this to individual origins. Pivot point to individual origins. And then we will just alt select loops of legs, shift alt to select that whole loop that we made. And once you have selected them, you can hit E and then right click and then scale it a bit up, and then go Control B. You will bevel it, and then we can adjust the width and segments. So width, I guess this much would be nice. Okay, shape, we will take it around that much, or we will make it go About that much. That looks good. Okay, and now we will scale up everything that we have made. Okay, and now we can go mesh, separate, and selection. So now they are a different thing. So now you can select them and move them. Okay, Control C. So we will leave it the way they are currently. We will just leave it the way they are. We will texture them later. You can still shift alt click and select them. So now we can go on and make the drawers, as we have got a nice beveled feet of our table. So let's do it. Tab, and it would be basically just the same process. Select this E and Z, tab into one, numpad one, so you can see better. G and Z to your desired length. To me, this much looks fine. Next, we want to extrude a bit more for the floor, then for the flat surface, and then E and Y to get our drawer extruded. We will do again E, and we will get a bit of depth over this side. Next, we will select this side and go E and extrude it, shift extrude it until that roughly, and then we will select these two, E, Z, and take them up, change into 3 to look better at it, and then go E and Z, or actually Control Z, G and Z, and done. Now we will just select this side, or actually Control Z completely, and we will select until here, E and Z, until it basically just reaches there. So if you want, you can keep it like that way to keep your PC cabinets, but if it's for books or something, we need some segments over here to separate it. So we will add in Control R, segment, and Control R, one more segment, to basically make a partition over here. Select that, E, and take that in. So that will be one partition. In texture preview mode, exit out of tab, and it looks pretty good. We will texture it in the next part, so let's continue on with the modeling for now. So we will add in another loop cut and another loop cut over here. Select this, E to extrude, and just until there, G and X maybe. Okay, that will pull it. No, you leave it the way it is, and that's pretty much one drawer. If you want, you can add some legs to it, but it's fine that way and wouldn't really cause a difference if you don't add. But for the sake of this video, I will. So I will select that, turn off X-ray, Shift D and Y, G and Y to move it over this side, G and X, G and X. To move it over here, and just slide right in, Shift D and X to do the same on this side. That looks good. So now we can make it on this side as well, but you can just copy it the way we did this. So that's the video, guys, and thank you for watching. This was the part one of the modeling tutorial, basic modeling tutorial. This is my second one, and shading smooth looks weird. Let's just keep it flat for now. So that's the video, and thank you for watching.